We continue now at the top of Daf Lamed Dalet Amud Aleph Masechta Shabbos. This is Shabbos Daf 34a. The Gemara here is in the middle of a story about Rav Shimon bar Yochai when he emerged from the cave, and he said that he wanted to fix the world in some way. So he found out that there was a certain area which was a Safek Tumas Mace. There's a Safek whether there was a Beis HaKvaras here. So he wanted to fix that area, and the Gemara continues the story. Ve'islu tzara l'kohanim l'kufe. In this area, it was difficult for the Kohanim to traverse this area. Rashi explains Vislu Tsara Lakufe, Shaya Oso Shuksha Safik Bo, Mokam Maver Hoir Larabin. This area, this marketplace where the Safik existed, was a place where the people, the public passed by. Vakohanim Lohayu Choni Konisham Mimne Tumma. The Kohanim were not able to enter there. The Kohanim were not able to enter there because of Tumma. Vitzarach Lahakif Derech Acher Arch. They needed to go around a different way. They needed to go a longer route. So this was something which Rav Shimon bar Yochai wanted to fix. So Amari said, Iko Inish Diyoda Dischazik Hocha Tahara. Is there somebody who knows maybe that there's some kind of Tahara in this place? Amar Leahu Saba, so a certain elder said, Kan Kitzas Ben Zakai Turmusai Truma. It was over here that Ben Zakai cut these lupines of Truma. Ben Zakai, Rabbi Yochanan Ben Zakai, was a Kohen. So there was some kind of Chazaka of Tahara. Avar Iyu Nami Hachi, so he did this as well. So Rashi explains, what does it mean, Avid Iyu Nami Hachi? He did this as well. So Rashi says, Avid Iyu Nami Hachi, Hayim Mekatzitz Tormusin, he also cut Tormusin, Umashalichancham, he threw them there to this area. And a miracle happened, and anywhere there was a dead body, it kind of floated to the top. And then he was able to identify and put a sign around those areas of Kfaris. This is explained in the Psikta and in the Seder Zerami, the Yerushalmi. So that's how he solved the problem. The Gemara continues, Kol hecha dehave kashi tahari, any area where the earth was hard, he declared it tahar. V'chol hecha dehave rafi tzaini, any area where the earth was soft, he marked that off as an area where there was a kever. Amar hahu saba, certain elder said, this the same elder said, Tir ben Yochai beis hakvaras. So he said that Rav Shimon bar Yochai has now been metair, he's purified a place which is a beis hakvaras. He said this as a criticism. Amar lei said to him, "Ilmalei lo yisimanu, vafilo yisimanu v'lo nimnisimanu yafa atomer." Look, he said to the elder, "If you wouldn't have been part of this whole thing, or even if you were part of it but you didn't count, you weren't counted, meaning you didn't agree to what we were doing, that would be one thing. But achshav now, then you'd be correct. But achshav now, shayisa imanu v'nimnisimanu, you were with us when this happened, when we made this decision. You agreed with us at the time. So yomru zonos mefarchzo zu azu." It's like an expression. People are going to say that just like the Zonos, they make each other's hair look nice, so Talmidei Chachamim, certainly that is the case. So Rav Shimon bar Yochai meant that if Zonos are able to help one another, certainly Talmidei Chachamim should help one another, and it's inappropriate that you are now contradicting what I said when you were together with us. So Yav Be'enei V'nach Nafshei, he turned his eyes towards this elderly person and he died. Nafik Lashuka, then he went out to the marketplace, Chazia lo Yehuda ben Gerim. He saw Yehuda ben Gerim. Yehuda ben Gerim, of course, is at the beginning of the story. He was the reason why Rav Shimon bar Yochai had to run from the Romans in the first place. So Amar, he said, Adayin Yesh lo Zeba Olam, is this Yehuda ben Gerim still alive? Nazan bo Einov ve'aso gal shalat samos. He placed his eyes upon him and he became a heap of bones. Rashi says, Gal me'atzamos kemeis shenirkav besoro v'nafam izman harbe. It was as though he had died a long time ago, as if there was no flesh left. So Yehuda ben Gerim essentially punished for his role in this whole episode. Gemara now continues with the Mishnah. Gimel devarim sarach adam lomar besoch beso erev Shabbos imchashecha. There are three things that a person should say in his house on erev Shabbos as it's becoming dark. Isartem, eravtem, hadliku esaner. Did you take off the proper miser? Did you make the Erev properly, and did you light the candles? Safek chashecha, safek eina chashecha. If you have a doubtful time period, meaning Rashi explains, Bein Hashmash is where you're not sure whether it's nightfall or not. You're not sure whether Shabbos has begun. So in such a situation, Ein ma'asrin es avadai, you're not allowed to take ma'aser off things that for sure need ma'aser taken off. Ve'in matbilin es akelim, you're not allowed to be tovil the kelim. Ve'in madlikin es aneros, and you can't light candles at that time. Aval ma'asrin es hadmai, you are allowed to take ma'aser off demai, that stuff where it's a suffix whether ma'aser has been taken off. U'ma'orvin, and you're allowed to make an eruv. Ve'tomnin es achamin, and also you're allowed to insulate the hot food. Let's take a look at Rashi over here. What do you mean, Im Chashech? It sounds like right before Shabbos. Why right before Shabbos? Because if you remind them too early, they're going to say, oh, there's still plenty of time. The reminder won't be effective. Isartem, did you take off Meiser? Peros Ha'ilon Lesud Shabbos. The Peros Ha'ilon, did you take Meiser off them for the meal? Sha'af Achilas Arai Shel Shabbos. Kovas L'Meiser. Rashi adds over here that even a snack on Shabbos is considered a kvias for Meiser when it's specifically because of Shabbos. Kedaminim Emesachas Beitza, the Shabbos Onig Ikri, Mikol Shu'ave Onig. So when it comes to Shabbos, it's called an oneg. Anything that you have on Shabbos is an oneg Shabbos, and therefore you are required to take off Meiser. Erav Tem, Rashi says, Eruv Tchumen V'Chatzeros. We're talking about both Eruv Tchumen and Eruv V'Chatzeros. Eruv Tchumen, of course, allowing you to walk a certain distance on Shabbos, and Eruv V'Chatzeros allowing you to carry. V'Hani Trei Shaychil L'Memrinu B'Loshon She'ela. Now these two things you say in a way of asking, the Shema Kvar Asu, because maybe they were already done. So you're asking, did you do them? Avol Bener, when it comes to candle, Lo Shayach Had Lakosam, the Dover Hanira La'ayinu. So over there, by candle, it's not Shayach, because when you light a candle, it's obvious to everybody. So you're not asking, you're saying, light the candle. Obviously, you see that the candles have not been lit. Then the Mishnah said, Sovach HaSheikh, if you have a time of doubt, can go in Ben HaShmoshas, like Ben HaShmoshas, you're not sure if it's Shabbos or not, Ein Ma'aser Nesavadei D'Tikun Ma'al Yehu. You can't take off Meiser from something that for sure needs Meiser taken off, because that's a real Tikun. Avagav D'Shvus B'Almihi. Now, even though it's only a Durabonon, Kasavar Gozru Al HaShvus Afal Ben HaShmoshas. This opinion the Mishnah holds, that even something that's a Durabonon, but if it's a Tikun Ma'al Yehu, it's going to be a problem. Vein Matvila Nesakelem D'Havinami Shvus, being Tovel Kelem is also a Durabonon. Kidamim Mesachas Beitza, D'Nirak Mesach and Kli, it's like giving Mesach and Kli. You're not allowed to light the candles. Kol shekin, that's obvious. This is a suffix doraisa. This lighting candles is a doraisa on Shabbos. Vizu vein sarach lomar zu katani. The mission is going to one thing and then saying the obvious. Avol ma'asrenes hadamai. You are allowed to take ma'aser off demai. Delo dami lemisakin. That's not really, doesn't really appear to be misakin. Derov ame haaretz ma'asrenes, because most ame haaretz take off ma'aser. You're really not fixing this. Meiser was most likely taken off. Uma'arvin Eruv, you're allowed to set up an Eruv of a Gemara. Parech Hatnan La'el Im Chashecha. So the Gemara is going to ask, what are you talking about? By Eruv, it says you're supposed to do that before it gets dark. Eravtim, that's why you say Eravtim. Mekame de la'ave Suffolk, that sounds like you should do it before the Suffolk time period. And finally, the Mishnah said, V'tomna Nesacham in Noslan Bekupa Shel Muchen Lios Chomam Mishtamer Behen. What you do is you take the hot food and you put them with, you surround them with pads, and that insulates them. Avol Mishachashecha Vada in Tomnin Behen Kin Meforsh Begemar. Once it becomes dark, you're not allowed to do that, as the Gemara will explain. The Gemara says, Minoan Emilia, how do we know all of this is true? Amar Rabbi Yeshua ben Levi, Rabbi Yeshua ben Levi says, Amar Kra, Pasuk says, V'yadato ki sholom alecho fakarton avecho velo sechta. Essentially, you should know that there's peace in your house, and you should make sure there's no sin. So you should say over in your house the certain things that need to be done, so no averus take place. Amar Rabbi Ravuna says, Afagav domar abonu shlosha dvarim tzorach odom lomar v'chulu, even though the Mishnah says you should say these three things before Shabbos. Tzarech lememrinu benichusa. A person should say them in a pleasant manner. Kihechi delekablinhu minei, in order that it be accepted. Amar Ravashi. Ravashi said, Ano lo shemia li had Rabbi Bar Ravuna. I didn't hear Rabbi Bar Ravuna say this. V'kiamti misvara, but I did it because it's a logical thing to do. The Gemara now asks, Haguf Akasha, there's an internal contradiction in the Mishnah. You say there are three things, it says in the Mishnah, there are three things that need to be said before Shabbos as it's getting dark. So, im chashecha, in savach chashecha, savach eino chashecha, lo. The implication is, really, you're saying these things right before it gets dark, not in the doubtful period, not when it's already become dark, where it may be Shabbos. However, v'hadur tani, then it says, savach chashecha, savach eino chashecha ma'arif. It seems to say you are allowed to set up an Eruv. You are allowed to make an Eruv in the doubtful time period. So, is Eruv something you need to do before, or is it something that you can even do in the doubtful time period of Bein HaShmoshes? So now the Gemara, before the Gemara gives some answers to this question, the Gemara, before the Gemara says the answer, the Gemara has an acronym over here, Simen Begufya Zimra Tzipra Bechavla Demilsa. Now the Gemara answers the question. Amar Rabbi Abba, Amar Rav Chiya Barashi, Amar Rav. So Rabbi Abba says in the name of Rav Chiya Barashi, in the name of Rav, Lokash, it's not difficult. Kan Beiruve Techumen, Kan Beiruve Chatzeros. There's actually a distinction between an Eruv that's made for Tchum and an Eruv that's made for carrying, an Eruv Chatzeros. And Rashi explains. Rashi says, Beiruve Techumen, Tikun Ma'alya, this is a real fixing. This is something that's problematic on Shabbos. Das Mechur Abonin Techumen Akroi. Because the concept of Techumen The Rabbanan relied it upon Psukim. Now, even according to the one who says that Tchum ultimately is the Rabbanan, like we say in Erevin, there is a drasha there. There is something in the Torah that sets up the concept of Tchum, even if it's the Rabbanan. But when it comes to Eruvi Chatzeros, Chumra Bialmahu, that is just a Chumra. It's a stringency. Velo mikri shvisa mal yos. It's not a real shvisa. Usveika de ben hashmashas shaper dummy. So if you have a situation of suffix like ben hashmashas, it's not going to be a problem in such a case. So by eruv echatzeros, you according to the Gemara here, you can be lenient when it's ben hashmashas, and by eruv etechumen, you're not allowed to be lenient to ben hashmashas. You do it right before. The Amar Rav, and Rava says, Amru lo shnayim tsevi irev aleinu. If two people say to one person to make an erev for them, le'echad irev olav mi ba'od yom. One of them, he makes the erev before Shabbos. Le'echad irev olav ben hashmashas. For the other one, he makes the erev ben hashmashas. Zeh she irev olav mi ba'od yom nechol eruv ben hashmashas. Now, for the person who he set up the erev before Shabbos, the erev gets eaten during ben hashmashas. Zeh she irev olav ben hashmashas nechol eruv mi shechashecha. And for the person who he set up the erev ben hashmashas, the erev gets eaten after dark. So the Gemara says, Rava says, Shneim kana Erev. Both of them, the Erev works. So Rashi explains, Shneim kanu Erev, delegabe hai shenechol ben hashmashas. Regarding the guy whose Erev got eaten at ben hashmashas, mashvinon le lelya. We say that ben hashmashas is considered night. V'yaminon kvar kidesh hayom ba'od ha'erev kayim. The kana Erev. And we say that the Shabbos already started when the Erev was in existence, and the Erev works for that guy. The halacha k'Rabbi Yossi, damar be'erev and suffik Erev kosher. Halacha is like Rabbi Yossi, when you have a suffik Erev, it's kosher. Well, l'gabe d'hai shehuna chola ben hashmashas. Now, regarding the guy where the Erev was set up at ben hashmashas, v'niskayim ad shechashech, and it lasted until dark, then, according to that perspective, mashvin l'ben hashmashas yimama, we say that ben hashmashas is considered daytime. V'adayin lo k'desh hayom k'shehunach, so it wasn't yet Shabbos when it was placed, which is proper, v'nimtza shehaya sham kvar b'shas k'nias Erev, so it was set up before Shabbos, and at the time of the kinyan, meaning ben hashmashas, when we're considering it night now, it is considered a good Erev. Essentially, Rava said we're going to take two leniencies in both directions. Now, we should point out over here what kind of Erev are we talking about. Rashi says we're talking about Erev Tchumen. Tosis has a little difficulty with this because we literally just said that by Erev Tchumen is where we're strict. And here we're taking a double leniency. So Tosis says that we're really talking here about Eruv Echatzera. So it is a machlokus what kind of Erev we're talking about. Tosis does explain on behalf of Rashi that Rashi might understand that by Erev Tchumen were strict l'chatzchila, but b'diavid we would be lenient. But in any case, Rava here is saying it works for both parties. So the Gemara says, manavshach, why should it work for both? Manavshach. E bein hashmashas yimamahu, if bein hashmashas is considered the daytime, basra likni kama lo likni. So then the second guy, he should have a good Erev, the first guy shouldn't have a good Erev. Vi bein hashmashas leil yehu, and if bein hashmashas is night, kama likni, so then the first guy should have a good Erev because he put it there before bein hashmashas, and it was konan bein hashmashas, basra lo likni, the last guy would not have a good Erev. So the Gemara answers, as we just mentioned, bein hashmashas sveikahu, sveikahu rabbon lakula. Bein hashmashas is actually a time of doubt, and since this is only midrabbonan, sveikahu rabbonan is lakula. The Gemara now says, V'yamar Rav, and Rav says, M'mnei ma amru ein tomnin bedover she'eno mosif hevel mishachashecha. Why do the Chachamim say that a person is not allowed to insulate food, even if the insulation is not adding any heat, once it gets dark? So the Gemara explains, Rav explains, Gezeira shema yarsiach. It is a gezeira that maybe you're going to come to actually boil the food. Maybe you'll come to add heat. Amar le Abai said, if so, ben hashmashas nami nigzor. Then that same gezeira should apply by ben hashmashas. And we just said that when it, we just said that at ben hashmashas, in the Mishnah says, v'tom n'nesachamin. You are allowed to insulate the warm food at ben hashmashas. So why don't we apply this gezeira at ben hashmashas as well? Amar le, he said back to him, stam kederos ros chosein. Most pots are actually already boiling. There's no real concern that they're going to cool off and you're going to try to reboil it, reheat it up again. It's only a minor concern, and therefore at ben hashmashas we're not going to be so worried. The Gemara says, V'yamar Rav, and Rava says, and we'll continue with Rava's statement on Daf Lamed Dalet Amid Beis in the next video.